Hey guys, welcome to Hip Hughes History. You didn't think it was out there. Who the heck does Federalist 51 as a video lecture? This guy. So let's giddy up, James Madison, guys. We're gonna whip the government into shape. Let's go on a journey learning. Alright guys, here we go, Fed 51. It's a big one, but it's really a short read, and definitely after you watch this video, read it because it's going to make a lot more sense. First, let's do purpose. What's the umbrella? What's the big idea? Well, I love the quote. He said, if men were angels, no government would be necessary. So he starts off the paper by saying, you know, anarchy bad. People will be like eating people's faces. So we need government, and we need a stronger government because remember, we're coming out of that Articles of Confederation experience, and we're definitely going to have a stronger federal government, and that's evident from what came out of the Constitutional Convention. So in a sense, Madison in this paper is defending the Constitution as still protecting liberty. We're going to have a stronger government, but we're still going to protect liberty. So he's going to go down two different avenues. We're going to look first at really the independence of the branches, and then secondary, we'll look at his mentioning of factions again. So giddy up for the learning. Let's do it. So first we want to protect the people against tyranny, and obviously he's arguing that the best way of doing that is having independent branches. He says,
but the great security against the gradual concentration of the several powers in the same department consists in giving to those who administer each department the necessary constitutional means and personal motives to resist encroachments of the other.
So that mumbo jumbo basically means tall walls, baby. All right, we want each department to be independent. Number one, that means that they can't be setting each other's salaries. That would definitely try to control them. And they really shouldn't be picking each other, right? If I pick you, you in a sense owe me something. So most of the electionary processes really have to do something with the state or the people and not the other branches. And Madison even points out, he goes, look, the one kind of loophole is the judicial branch. We can't let the commoners pick the judicial branch. We have to have them pick from the executive department and the Senate, but that's why we give them lifetime jobs. That goes back to that idea, then they have that independence and they don't have to rely on their jobs and they can just kind of act as a judiciary all by themselves. He goes on in this first line of defense to talk about how, look, even in the legislative branch, which is the most powerful branch, Madison says that. He goes, because look, it comes from the people, it's the will of the people, so we have to give it power, but we don't want that power then to be turned against other people, so what do we need to do? We need to chop. We need to even break up the legislative branch. So we have a House and we have a Senate and we have checks and balances between those. So all of this is a deliberate design. And Fed 51 is arguing that you need to chill if you're worried about us taking away your liberty. Because we have all of these built-in machinery to guard against that. The robot will save you all. All right, let's look at factions. So Madison and Hamilton, too, are obsessed with factions. They're really worried, and this is elite theory, that the largest faction in this new republic, which is going to be really a class idea, the lower class, they're always going to have this tendency, according to Hamilton and Madison, to want to take from the other classes, from the minority, from the rich. So therefore, we have to have mechanisms or something built into the system to make sure that that type of tyranny doesn't occur. So this is a great quote to start with.
It is of great importance in a republic not only to guard against the oppression of the rulers, but to guard one part of the society against the injustice of the other. Different interests necessarily exist in different classes of citizens. If a majority is united by a common interest, the rights of the minority will be insecure.
So what he basically is going to say is that this is a worry. So this is why we need a big government. This is why we need a large republic, because the larger the republic, the larger the amount of people. And more people is more factions that'll be drawn to each other, almost like a give or take, like I'll join your faction and then he'll join his faction. And this will kind of, in a sense, protect us against from one faction and uniting, and that would be the poor faction, I think, according to Hamilton and Madison, and then eating the rich. And then he goes on to say that because of the design of the Constitution, we have these multiple access points to government, so every faction will have like a breather. Every faction, if it gets too upset and wants to do something, they have, in a sense, an entrance lane to the highway of government. and there's lots of different exits and there's lots of different speed bumps, but no one group is going to dominate the highway. How about that? So remember, factions, large republic, and then we don't have to worry about the revolution. All right, guys, so sum it up. Basically, this is separation of powers and checks and balances, right? He's saying, look, if we're going to have a government, not only are we going to have federalism is the division of power between the federal government and the state governments, but then we're going to take that federal government, we're going to chop it up into a judiciary, a legislative, and an executive, and then we're even going to take the legislative and chop, and we're going to keep doing that until you feel secure in your liberty. Fed 51, nail it to the wall because it's done, baby. Now go read it. And remember, guys, look at me sweating for the learning, guys. Make sure you subscribe to Hip Hughes History because you're going to save a pony, and everybody loves ponies. And remember, guys, where attention goes.